Hi, my name is Tumelo Modiba, and I'm here outside the Evolutionary Studies Institute to find out more about pollen tracking and what is aeropollenology. Frank, can you just tell me what is aeropollenology?
Okay, so aeropollenology is the study of pollen and spores in the air, and the recording, documenting of them, and calculating how many pollen and spores you have in 1 cubic meter. The spore trap is a seven-day volumetric trap. So inside the spore trap you find a drum which is run by a clockwork, and it turns in 7 days, makes one round. And on the drum you find a small transparent film covered with Vaseline. The Vaseline is a highly sticky substance. So everything which is sucked into the spore trap will end up on that tape, on that sticky tape. Mm-hmm. And we remove this sticky tape, chop it up in bits of 5 centimeters, because 5 centimeters are actually 1 day, and then put it on a glass slide, mount it with a little cover slip, and then we can analyze it under the light microscope.
Mm-hmm. And can you just tell me, what do you do at the Evolutionary Studies Institute in terms of aeropollenology?
Okay, so I'm a master's student in paleopollenology, meaning that I analyze fossil pollen. But my role in this project is to analyze the modern pollen that we find in the air. So what we do is we get the strip from the spore trap, we harvest it, and we make microscope slides. And from then on, I just count the types of pollen that are in the slides, the pollen and the spores that are in the slides. And we do that for each day of the week, so from Monday to Sunday. And then we upload this information on the website, and the doctors use it to just say which types of pollen are allergenic and the number of pollens that are high and numbers of pollen that are low.
And then what's the relation between pollen tracking and people who suffer from pollen-related allergies?
Your body might react in an allergic way against certain pollen types. So the doctor is testing that with an allergy kit. So you might have your extract of birch pollen, and if you put that on your skin, or maybe even like scratch it lightly, your skin will react towards it if you have an allergy. Mm-hmm. And it will react in a way that it shows you a swelling, like a red swelling. Mm-hmm. It's histamine, basically.
And then I just would like to know, in terms of climate change, how does that affect pollen tracking?
It's a global phenomenon, actually, that with the increasing temperature, that your absolute pollen productivity increases, and what you get on top of that is a shift of the flowering season. So the flowering might start earlier because it's triggered by temperature, and it might take longer. So you don't actually only get an actual increase of the total amount of pollen in there, but on top of that, it might even start earlier.